Hey everyone, welcome back to the Gen AI learning series by StarAgile. Today, we are wrapping things up with the final video of a series, which is to create an HR assistant using Gen AI. I'm Huzaifa. If you have been following along, we've been on an exciting journey to explore how Gen AI is changing the way we work, create, and solve problems. If you have missed out on any of our previous videos, here's the link for you to check out. And before we get started, if you'd like to see an advanced Gen AI course, remember to drop a yes down in the comments. If enough of you are interested, we'll definitely make it happen. So let's dive in and get started. Hi everyone. In this session, we are going to create a simple capstone project that will allow us to combine all the previously learned topics together. Here, we are going to use the concept of RAG, agents, and tool to create an HR assistant that can answer questions for each and every employee of an organization. Let's see what project we are trying to create here. So in this, the goal is to essentially query different offer letters of each and every employee of a company. So imagine having a chatbot that can take your offer letter, and if you have any questions pertaining to your offers, it can read that offer letter and give you the answers from your specific offer. Right? So it will be able to answer some frequently asked questions, and also it will be able to compute the total salary. Right? So in this particular project, the tech stack that we are going to use will use FAISS as a vector store for retrieving and embedding our documents. The large language model will be GPT-40 mini that will allow us to interact with the underlying large language model. We'll define tools to calculate salary and answer some frequently asked questions as well. So all of there will be two tools. One which will be used to calculate salary, and the second tool that will answer the questions other than the salary calculations. And last but not the least, we'll combine everything together inside a LangChain workflow. So this particular agent will be first able to read the offer letters which are retrieved by the RAG, compute the salary, and also keep a track of the conversation that we had with the employee of that specific company. So for this chatbot, we can ask different questions, such as, first of all, we can ask the model, how many days off do I get? How many leaves can I get? What's my total compensation? What's my work schedule? Right? So all of these questions can be answered by looking at the offer letter for that specific company. So without further delay, let's implement this project in Python. So as always, we are going to start by importing our dependencies first. So here you can see we are first importing the load.env to load our environment variables. Chat OpenAI to create the large language model for interacting with the customer, or in this case, our employees. Hugging Face embeddings to embed each and every offer letter that is pertaining to each employee. We'll also use the text loader to load those documents and embed it inside our vector store. FAISS is our vector store this time. The prompt template here will allow us to templatize the input prompt that will set the user instruction for the model, the system level instruction for the model, as well as the input or the offer letter for that specific employee. And the messages placeholder is required to keep a track of the previous chat history. Agents, we are going to use create OpenAI functions agent because we want to define an agent using OpenAI, and an agent executor to execute that respective agent. And the tools will allow us to define the tools one by one. So first, let's take a look at some of the offer letters that we have available. So in this particular demonstration, we have 6 or 7 offer letters, and each offer letter basically contains basic information about an employee. So here we have details like an employee code, what role this employee is currently working at, what's the work location, what are their work hours, the annual leave policy, what's the fixed compensation, and the corresponding performance bonuses. So here you can see all of this information is part of each and every offer letter that is present here. This is for employee who is working as a developer. Employee code is 102. This is for a data scientist. Employee code is DS105. This is for HR. Employee code HR103, and so on. So each and every employee offer letter contains certain fixed compensation and a performance bonus. So the goal here is to basically use a salary calculator that can first of all combine these two together and calculate a total compensation by multiplying the compensation and the percentage and giving you the final answer. So over here, first we'll start by defining our tools one by one. Right? So we'll first begin by defining our tools. So let's create the first tool, which is called salary calculator. So for this salary calculator, we are going to define two inputs. The first input is going to be the base package. What's the base salary? So in this case, this base salary will be the fixed compensation that we are going to get. So in this case, this fixed compensation here is $85,000. And secondly, we'll also need the percentage of the fixed salary, that is essentially the variable component, right? So all of this information will be returned to us by the large language model. So this tool is going to take the percentage and the base salary as the two inputs in order to proceed forward. So let's rename these input parameters. Let's call them base salary and bonus percentage itself. And then next, we are going to define a doc string that is going to contain what this particular tool does. This particular tool is calculating total salary by adding the base salary and the bonus amount. And how are we going to extract these? So remember that these base salary and percentages will represent string, because there will be a dollar in front with a comma in between, and percentage also will have some special characters. So we will need to pre-process these strings first before we can multiply or add them together. So what we will do here is basically we'll first take the base salary and we'll replace the dollar symbol with an empty string. So all of these dollar signs that are part of the text strings will be replaced, and we'll only have basically the numbers available. And also we'll replace all the commas in between. So there could be commas there as well. So we'll replace comma and dollars so that we are only left with numbers. And then we'll convert those strings into float, right? So we'll have the base salary in that fashion. Similarly, for bonus as well, for bonus, we multiply our base with the percentage, but after stripping our percentage sign. So remember, in the percentage as well, there will be a percentage sign towards the end. So we can easily strip it using the strip function. And then whatever float is there, we'll multiply that with the base salary and to calculate here the bonus of that particular employee. And total salary is going to be the sum of base and bonus combined. So once this is done, we can return a string which says the total salary we have already calculated here, the base salary which has been extracted above, and the bonus that we have extracted, right? So all of this combined together will give us the total salary back. And we can then write an except block if a particular exception has occurred. So here we'll say basically return error calculating my total salary. So for this particular tool, we'll then wrap it inside our tool decorator to make sure that this tool has been successfully created. This is the first tool that we have defined, which easily calculates the salary based upon the inputs of base salary and bonus percentages. Next up, let's define a second tool that can answer all the other general HR related queries. So remember, this particular tool will be called only when you are computing the salary. For all the other questions, this second tool will be called, and this second tool, the description, as you can see, this tool says this is answering general HR questions based on the employee's information, right? So for this tool, again, we are writing a try-catch block. Now remember that this particular tool, the answer for these questions will already be coming from the large language models only. This tool is only meant to return back the responses back to the user. All right, so we are not performing any calculations here. We'll get the employee information that is requested, and we'll return that employee information in this particular fashion. Right. So if you do not want to return the query back, I can even remove this part. And I will simply say that based on the employee information, whatever employee information has been requested, it will be returned back to the user itself. So in this particular tool, we are answering any HR questions, and the response which we will get from the large language model will be returned back to the user in this format, which is written here. And then we'll accept the exception here, and we'll, if there are any particular errors present, in that particular case, we are saying that error processing the query that was given to us. And then we'll combine these two tools together. So let's do it in another line. So let's define all of our tools, right? So we'll combine these two tools together. So we'll define a list that contains both of our tools that we have created. The first tool to calculate our salary, and a second tool to answer any other HR questions that a particular employee could have. After this, we have to basically load our documents. So remember, all of these individual documents, they have to be loaded into our vector store so that we can retrieve it using RAG. So for doing this, what we are going to do is we are going to iterate through each file, right? So what I will do is I'll iterate through each file and load and append that into a doc list. So first, let's create a list of input documents. Then we are going to iterate through each file in our current working directory. So for listing the files, we can use the function os.listdir. right? And this will basically list all the files in our current working directory. And we'll check if the file is ending with .txt. Remember that in this folder, there are other files as well. We only want the files that are text files, right? So all the files that are ending with .txt, I'm using those files only. So what I will do is I'll basically take that file and I will create a loader by using or loading that specific file. And whatever file has been loaded, I'll append that file in my input documents list, right? So I will extend my input documents with the new file that has been loaded here. Okay, so now what this will do, this will allow me to load all of the input documents easily. So I can print my input documents list to verify whether all the input documents have been properly loaded. So as you can see, in my current working directory, there are 5 offer letters present. So all of these 5 offer letters have been successfully loaded, and the corresponding information for each offer letter is also present in the respective file. One thing you would have noticed here is this time I'm not using any chunking as such, because these offer letters are sufficiently small and we do not need any chunking, because we want all the information pertaining to an employee part of a single document retrieval. To make things simple, we are not chunking it for this particular demonstration. But if you wish, you find the offer letters are too big to be inserted in one go, you can use chunking as we have demonstrated in our previous demonstrations. So now we are ready to embed these documents into our vector stores. But before doing that, we need to create our embeddings model. For embeddings, we are again using Hugging Face embeddings model. And once our embeddings have been defined, we are ready to define our vector stores. So for a vector store, we are using FAISS. We are going to load the documents, pass the input documents that we have created in the embedding model to embed these documents inside our vector store. Next up, we are going to define a retriever that will retrieve the documents which are matching the user's input. So let's quickly recap what we have done until this point. Till here, we have defined both of our tools. One tool to compute salary, second tool to answer all the other questions except for salary calculations. We are combining these tools into a single list. We took all the offer letters and ingested it inside a single vector store, which later will be retrieved using the retriever that we have defined over here. So up until now, our vector store is ready and our tools are ready. Now it's time to implement the agent. So in order to implement the agent, the first thing that we will do is define our large language model itself. So the large language model here is basically GPT-40 mini, and we need to define our API key as well. This API key is basically going to be generated from our environment variable itself. And secondly, we are going to define our prompt. Now the prompt is very important again, because this prompt is going to contain a system level instruction that will tell large language model what it needs to do. So for this large language model, this is an HR assistant who is going to provide the employee information depending upon the employee information provided below, right? So here you can see I'm clearly asking the model to provide the information and answer the question by looking at the below present context. This context is the retrieved information for that specific employee. Human is going to contain the instruction that the user has given. And finally, a messages placeholder to basically work as a scratch pad for our agent. Remember, in this last class, I have mentioned that a scratch pad is the place where agent is going to perform its logical reasoning. All right. So whatever the agent thinks, all those inputs will be provided within the scratch pad for the agent to use. This is mandatory whenever you are using an agent invocation. So we have defined a prompt, we have defined our large language model as well. So now let's basically begin by asking the simple questions to an user here. Okay, so before that, let's define our agent as well. So here we'll call the OpenAI functions agent, and we'll tie up LLM, tools and prompt together. We'll define our agent executor as well. This agent executor will be able to execute our agent on the mentioned tool, and verbosity here is mentioned as true so that we get to know what the agent is doing one after the other. Okay, so here if you set verbose to false, it will not show you its interim thinking. It will just give you the responses that you have requested. So over here we have defined our agent, and we have also defined our executor that will execute the functions that we call it to do. So now we are ready for invocating our agent. So first thing that we will ask an employee is their employee code. So let's define a variable to store our employee code. And we will say input your employee code. And what we will do is we'll retrieve our employee's information by calling the get retrieve or get relevant documents by the employee code. And in order to retrieve just a single document back, because we need just one document for each employee, which is the most relevant one. So I will set the parameter k to 1. This will just retrieve the top matching document only. It will not give me more than one document. And finally, once this document has been retrieved, let's just play it and once and see if the answers which I'm getting are correct or not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass in this particular employee code, which is ANL104. And after that, let's see if we have correctly, you know, identified the right document or not. So you can see the retrieved document that we have received. For that retrieved document, the text or the file name in this particular case is ANL104.txt, which is correct, right? And the content for this particular page is also basically containing that employee's information only. This particular functionality will be able to retrieve the information for each and every document, right? And once we have the information, now we are ready to answer any queries that a particular employee could have. So then let's quickly define a loop. In this specific loop, we are going to ask the user their specific queries. So in this particular case, we are asking the user what are your questions that you want the answers to happen. And then finally, we are using the agent executor to invoke our agent. The input which we are passing is the query that the user has entered, and the context that we have already loaded is essentially the employee info that we have created above. And once the result is back, we are going to print the response back that we are getting as an answer from the model. All right, that is basically the flow that we are currently going to follow. All right. So let's execute this. And now let's ask some simple questions to the model. So for this particular employee that we have retrieved the document, which is essentially the employee code ANL104, right? So let's ask few questions. So which role am I currently working at? So in this particular case, this will enter an agent information, and you can see here, based on the information for this employee, all of this are available. And for this particular role, it is basically saying that the role which I am currently working at is a business analyst role. Okay, so here you can see you are currently working as a business analyst in this company. Let's ask another question. So let's ask, what's my total salary? So this time, this particular function has been invoked, and here you can see the base salary is asked to be at 95,000, and the percentage is basically at 11%. So here you can see it is multiplying it together. So 95,000 and whatever 11% of 95,000 comes out to be, it is adding these two together to calculate the final answer. And you can see the finished response that we get, your total salary is $105,000, $105,450. Let's also continue and let's ask the model, what am I working hours? So this time again, it is going to invoke, and based upon the input that the model has received, you can see it has correctly answered that the working hours are from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Let's also ask, what's my work location? So you can see here, this time based on the employee information, the work location that we have been identified is Boston. That actually is correct, right? So as you can see, it's very easy for this particular model to answer all the relevant questions looking at the context that is present inside our employee's information file. So in this particular hands-on demo, what have we done? So we basically have successfully built our own AI assistant that can retrieve the relevant information for any given employee from looking at their employee code. And then whatever information is present within that offer letter, it is able to answer all the relevant questions for that employee using that particular context that we have added. So I hope this entire journey has been helpful for you to understand the different components of an agentic framework, agents, tools, RAG, etc. Thank you very much. I'll see you along. And that's a wrap. This was a final session of our Gen AI learning series, and we've loved having you along for the ride. If you found this series helpful, remember to hit that subscribe button and give it a thumbs up. It really helps us out. Also, if you are looking to level up with globally recognized certification in automation testing and Gen AI, check out our StarAgile certification programs. The links are down in the description. Thanks for watching and keep learning. I'll see you in the next one.